I'm kicking off with a sarnie that's a personal favourite.
It's inspired from a trip to America that has also been inspired by Italy. It's a meatball sub sandwich.
Made from beef and pork meatballs, cooked in a tomato sauce and wedged in a soft sub roll. This great American snack is European at its heart.
Most of the Italian immigrants that went to the States came from southern Italy, and meatballs are a bit of a staple there and are absolutely delicious. And over time, it's kind of developed and grown into this lovely sandwich. Generationally, it's moved on to suit that American palate with a real nod to that Italian heritage.
The meatballs start with minced beef and some finely chopped rosemary. And then for extra flavour, the pork from two sausages, as well as onion and garlic powder.
Because of that lovely Italian heritage, I'm going to put in 40 grams of grated Parmesan cheese. It's salty, it's got acidity to it. I mean, it also tastes of Italy.
A handful of breadcrumbs and a splash of milk will bind it all together. Season with salt and pepper and get your hands in.
Work it around.
Then roll it into golf ball-sized meatballs.
The beautiful thing about meatballs is, I mean, it's not a burger. It's similar in texture. You can do a bit more with a meatball. It can go into sauces, which is exactly what we're going to do here.
But cooking sauces and cooking meatballs demands very different levels of heat. So I'm setting up my barbecue accordingly. I've preheated my coals in a kettle and I'm arranging them using heat-resistant gloves.
What I've done is kind of push some into one end so they kind of slope down. So I've got a varying degree of heat, hotter at one end, cooling towards the other. I mean, I say cooler, it's still very, very hot, but it will allow a bit more control of your cooking.
My meatballs need to go over the hottest part of the coals to sear and colour on the outside.
They're beginning to sizzle straight away.
And on the slightly cooler part goes my sauce, which starts with olive oil.
Like all good Italian-style tomato sauces, some garlic. And I've got four cloves of it here.
A classic passata goes in next, followed by an ingredient that is somewhat less than authentic.
Shop-bought barbecue sauce. Now, you could make your own, that's fine. But this is, I mean, it's kind of like a rich, sugary, bittersweet ketchup, and it's delicious, OK? Now, this obviously isn't classic Italian cookery. However, it does sit in that American side of it now.
For an extra kick, I've got some dried hot chili flakes. And lastly, it needs a splash of water. That can simmer away whilst I keep turning my meatballs.
Look at that. They're beginning to cook up. They're getting some colour on them and that lovely crust that you get on them. And that's what you want, the flavour, the texture of roasted and cooked meat on a barbecue.
Once the meatballs have a good colour all over, pop them into the tomato sauce to poach for around 5 minutes.
You can already tell that this is going to be much more than just your average sandwich.
And it deserves much more than just your average cheese.
This is mozzarella cheese, but it's been smoked. Its real name is scamozza, but smoked mozzarella is a lot easier to say. So I'm just going to slice it. Quite thick, lovely slices, because I want this to go into my meatball sandwich.
A buttered roll of your choice, and we're ready to start building.
Four meatballs with a nice coating of the tomato sauce. All that sauce. Two or three pieces of the smoky cheese. Fresh basil leaves. Then you just put the sandwich into some tin foil and roll it up.
These subs are getting a double barbecuing. Chuck them back over the coals until the bread crisps up and the cheese melts.
5-6 minutes, maybe a bit more. It's going to be lovely. I'm just going to unwrap it. Oh, look at that. There's something so exciting. Gooey, melted, stringy cheese. The bread's toasty and crisp. To finish it off, pickled gherkins. And then lastly, dried crispy onions. Sprinkle them over the top. And if you look at that, I mean, there's a sandwich, right? And then there's like a sandwich. And this is a sandwich.
Before I start on my sausages, I need to prep one of the most mouth-watering things about a hot dog, the onions.
Now, one of my favourite smells from childhood memories is the smell of onions from hot dog stands, you know, on the way to rugby matches or football matches. That smell is incredible. Straight away, they start sizzling. Smells like you're walking to a football match.
The pan is directly on the coals, giving a strong heat to brown and caramelise the onions, whilst my jumbo butcher's sausages are getting the kebab treatment.
So with a long metal skewer, stick it into one end, gently feed it through all the way out to the other.
These help the sausages keep their shape and are handy for turning them on the grill.
I love the way that Germans have embraced the hot dog sausage and taken it to another level with some spicing, using curry. A currywurst is one of the most amazing, beautiful dishes. I want to have the same sort of flavours. So here, just got some simple curry powder. Rub it in. Gets a nice yellow coating. I really want to take this away from being an American-style hot dog and fully embracing the European style of sausage and flavour.
To the currywurst, I'm adding a twist you normally wouldn't associate with summer barbecues, pigs in blankets.
But I'm here to tell you that pigs in blankets aren't just for Christmas. It's for the summertime too. Get your smoked streaky bacon, stick it onto a board, stretch it. This is going to help ensure that it doesn't unravel. And then get yourself a cocktail stick and secure that bacon in place. Well, that's what you want. I mean, already that looks like the ultimate sausage, doesn't it? Long, big, covered in curry powder and wrapped in bacon.
My sweet smelling onions come off. Grill goes back on, ready for the sausages.
The heat coming off these coals is really quite powerful, so I haven't put the grill really low to it. It's a little higher, because I want these sausages to cook quite slowly. We've all been to those barbecues when the grill is too hot and you've had a sausage that's black on the outside and raw in the middle. We do not want that.
They should take around 10 minutes to cook. Turn every now and then while you get on with making a really nice mayonnaise. Start with a finely chopped shallot, some thinly sliced cornichons, and a good dollop of gorgeous German mustard.
Now, I love German mustard.
Next in is a big wadge of mayonnaise. A good pinch of salt, some freshly chopped dill, and my classy condiment is done.
Now, these guys smell amazing. I mean, it's a mixture between sausage, bacon, and curry. I mean, those are just three things that really should be together more often, I think.
Time to put it all together. Onions first.
Now, this is a simple French baguette. It's just been buttered, but you could use a softer brioche bun if you wanted to, whichever is your favourite. So the sausage goes into the bun. A couple of pieces of gherkin.
Lastly, I've got some slices of applewood smoked cheese, which I'm using rind and all.
So this barbecue, it's got the hot coals on the top. It's kind of got a little cupboard underneath. So these guys are just going to go into the grill part now, sitting there until that cheese melts. And that might take 5 minutes, might take 10.
If you don't have a shelf, wrap them in foil like the meatball subs and stick them on the coals.
That is perfect. Grilled, toasty, and a little bit crispy. I mean, how amazing do they look?
A lovely dollop of mustard mayonnaise, a sprinkling of sliced spring onions, and it's ready to eat.
That's not even fair to call that a hot dog. That is an ultimate barbecue, cheesy, sausagey, bacony, oniony beast. Look at it.
My pimped up German hot dog, a new barbecue classic.